It is spinning and it is revolving also around the sun. Similarly, Earth is also a planet. So Earth is also moving. Continuously it is moving. It is very active, okay? It is not static. It is moving continuously. It is moving and it is showing two type of movement. Okay? So Earth is having two types of movement. One is rotation. One movement we used to call rotation and another movement we used to call revolution. So today we are going to know about both the movement of the earth. Okay, this rotation and this revolution. One by one I will explain you what is rotation and what is revolution. So children, rotation is the movement of the earth on its own axis. You can see here it is an imaginary line. Actually there is no axis, only we have imagined like that we are rotating anything. You rotate anything, then you can see one line over there through which line it will rotate. Ball you spin, okay, you spin one ball or one top you spin, you will find one imaginary line around which it will rotate, okay? So Earth is also rotating, spinning around the imaginary line, and that imaginary line is known as axis. So the rotation is the movement of the Earth around its axis, movement of the Earth along its axis, okay? What is the rotation? Rotation is the movement of the Earth in its own axis. Okay, what happened due to this rotation? Due to this rotation, the one face of the earth, okay, will have the sun rays and another face will lack sun rays, means another portion will be dark. Here sun rays is not falling, okay. For example, if I am facing this way, you will put the torch in front of me. Only this face will get the light of the torch. Back side of, means back head will not get the light of the torch. Now similarly it happened over here. When Earth is rotating, then what happened? One face is having the sun rays and another face is not having the sun rays. So the face that at any point on the time, only half of the earth faces the sun, any time, okay, only half, not full with face. If this face is facing the sun, opposite face will behind it. So the face which is having the sun rays, that side that will be the day and opposite of it, it will be night, okay children. And one rotation means when the earth is moving in its own axis, to complete one rotation, means if it is rotating, it will complete one rotation, it is taking 24 hours. Okay? So the time for one rotation is equal to 24 hours. Okay children? And due to rotation, what happened? Due to rotation, what happened? Day and night. Due to rotation, day and night happen. So like other planets, what we have learned? Like other planets, the Earth also continuously moves on its own axis. All the planets moving, spinning in its own axis, okay? Similarly, Earth, all the planets is rotating, spinning in its own axis. Similarly, Earth is also spinning in its own axis. Okay, children? So, the means it is one day. As the earth rotates, the part that faces the sun keeps changing because it is rotating. How I show like that, so if anything is rotating, children, for example, this book I'm rotating, then one face, one time it will be towards the sun by the sun, and another face is in opposite direction of the sun. Okay, again it will rotate, and which face was in the opposite direction of the sun, it will now come towards the sun, and what the face was in the direction it was towards the sun, it is now in opposite direction of the sun. Okay, so due to this continuously, this rotation, as the earth rotates, the part that faces the sun keeps changing. At any point of the time, one half of the earth faces the sun. Okay, the half that faces the sun has day, and the other half away from the sun has night. So due to rotation, what happened? Day and night. If anyone will ask, by what movement of the earth there is days and nights? Day and night, okay, so we can say rotation. Now come to the next movement of the, another movement of the earth, that is revolution. Children, as the earth is spinning in its own axis, it is also revolving around the sun, same time, okay. It is spinning in its own axis, day and night is also going on, and then it is revolving, okay, around the sun also. And it is also a fixed path in which part is used to revolve around the sun, and that fixed path is known as orbit. So this is known as orbit. You can see this is not circular path, this is elliptical path. You can see over here, okay. So this is not circular path, this is elliptical path. So when the earth is in this position and in this position, it will be far away, and when it is in this position, it is the near to the sun. You can see here. Okay, children. Now children, due to this revolution, what happens? Season, changing of season happens. The revolution, changing of season take place, okay?
Similarly, here also one portion is having day and one portion is having night.
But children, in near the equator, the amount of sun, the area near the equator will get equal amount of sun throughout the year. So there is no season change also, and there is having equal duration of day and night. Means 12 hours day and 12 hours night. So they are having equal, we can say equal duration of day and night. But the area which is near the pole, you can see here is the pole. Due to this spinning also, you can see it is always, there is a day. Because spinning in this direction, now if it is spinning, then there is day only. All time there is day. And this, the area near the southern pole, all time there will be night. Okay? Similarly, here also you can see, this is only now, all time it is having day, the southern pole, and this northern pole is all time having night. So the duration of the day and night near the pole is 6 months. Okay, 6 months they are having day and 6 months they are having night. And the duration of the day and night near the equator is 12 hours. 12 hours day and 12 hours night. So what we have learned about this second movement, as the earth rotates, it also moves around the sun on its orbit. The movement of the earth on its orbit around the sun is called revolution. Okay, you can see it is moving around the sun in its orbit. That is the fixed part, elliptical part. And this movement is only known as revolution. The earth takes 365 days or 1 year to complete one revolution. How much time you are it is taking? 365 days to complete one revolution. If we will start from here, this earth will come back again in this position after 365 days. That is equal to 1 year. And within the year, there will be, you can see, these many seasons is there. Summer, autumn, winter and spring. And the tilted axis of the earth and revolution only causes the changing of season. So when the earth revolves, one side of it tilted towards the sun, the hemisphere that is tilted towards the sun has summer. You can see here, okay, which is tilted towards the sun, that hemisphere is having summer season. Yet it is having summer season. And the hemisphere that is tilted away from the sun is having winter season. You can see it is tilted away from the sun, so that is having winter season. So both the hemisphere also experience autumn and spring season between the winter and summer season. And the equator gets the same amount of sunlight throughout the year. It does have 12 hours each of day and night. So what we have learned today, children, we have learned about the movement of the earth. And the earth shows two types of movement, that is rotation and revolution. Due to rotation, rotation causes day and night. Revolution causes changing of season. Not only revolution, due to tilted axis also, okay? Causes changing of season, okay? And the duration taken by the rotation is 34 hours, that is 1 day. In revolution, what the duration is there? 365 days or 1 year. So thank you, children. Have a nice day.